Hey everyone, welcome to Hanson Never Done Farms. Arisha here. Just wanted to give you an update on the goings-on around here. Sorry it's been a long time since we've touched base with y'all, but hopefully we can start making up for that. So I'm out here with the goats today, and it's breeding season. We're full into it, so let's get you caught up on what's going on. Miss Clara was bred on the 13th of this month, September, and she has a due date, a possible due date of February 5th. She is bred to Smokin, Primavera Farms, Smokin, and I'll be, you know, keeping my eye on her, making sure she doesn't come back into heat. But I'm pretty excited about this breeding. We bred her to Loki last year, and I was okay with those babies, of course. Those girls are just so sweet. But I want to see what she'll do with Smokin this year. So anyways, that's what we did there. And now to update you on Elsa. If you remember, we had her in with Smokin, and I didn't see any signs of breeding, but after the given time I took her out and she tested positive. If you remember correctly, we did a p-test on her and she was positive. So I was pretty happy, thinking, you know, it had taken. But I think I told you guys the p-test has a 90% accuracy. Well, sadly, she fell into that 10% range. I checked her again, tested her again about a month later, and she came back negative. Waited a few weeks, tested her again, and it also was negative. So things got a little busy. We had planned a vacation, so figured we'd deal with it whenever we got back. When we came back, we called our local vet. I had my suspicions on what was going on, called our local vet, and while they had an ultrasound and they could ultrasound her for pregnancy, their ultrasound wasn't strong enough to look into her and really see her, get a good view of her ovaries and stuff. I suspected that she might have an ovarian cyst. I had read up on that, and just due to the fact that since I had bought her in March, I had never seen any heat signs from her. And so, you know, that was just a suspicion. So our local vet was unable to do it. They recommended that we take her up to Oregon State University out of Corvallis. And so I called, we made an appointment, and that's where we took her. And sure enough, guys, she had an ovarian cyst. So they gave her a shot to help take care of that, and they seeded her, which they're like a little tampon they insert into their vagina, and it releases the hormone to allow them to come back into heat. A lot of breeders do it. Sheep breeders, if you have ever watched Sheepishly Me, Sandy Brock, she does it with her sheep to sync their heat cycles out of season. Typically the Nigerian dwarfs don't need it because, you know, they cycle every 3 weeks year round. But because she had been so long without a heat, we wanted to sync it, wanted to get it straightened up. So anyway, she's been seeded. That comes out on Sunday. I don't know what day that is. This is Tuesday, so it'll come out. Actually, I take it back. Sunday, I give her a shot of luteolize. I think that's how you pronounce it. And then Monday, we take out the seeder, and the vet said within 4 to 5 days, we should see her come into heat. So we're hoping that the shot that they gave her initially took care of the cyst, and we will be able to get her bred. She will be bred to Smokin. He is not polled, she is polled, and Loki is polled. So I'm not comfortable breeding them together, so we will be breeding her to Smokin, and we'll see how that goes. and that's Panda. And my plans for Panda were actually to do my first attempt at line breeding. I am thinking I am going to breed her back to her sire. Her sire is Smokin. But I won't be breeding the four younger ones until January. So we'll see how that goes. I might change my mind. I might lose I might lose my nerve. So we'll see. I'm not for sure yet. Oh, and Maisie. We can't forget Maisie. Maisie will be bred to Loki again in January. This is Aspen's girl. She's eating her hay, but she is just a beautiful doling. I am really excited to see what she can do. Maisie, are you gonna say hi to the peoples? Are you gonna say hi, or are you just gonna keep eating? She's gonna keep eating, guys. She's not interested. She's kind of a snob. Not really, but anyways. And you can hear the chicks. These are the Bielefelder pullets. Some I raised, or some I hatched in the incubator, some I let a broody hatch. We have one little rooster that we kept back. But these guys are just about ready to go out to the pen with the other Bielefelders. I'm going to give them another, 2 to 3 weeks, let them get a little bit bigger. Guys, I just love her. This is, of course, Kalani's. This was the firstborn that you saw in whenever the five were born of Kalani's. This was the one that I had really, really hoped for. And so I'm just excited. I'm excited to see what she can produce. And Annabelle. Annabelle is blue-eyed and polled. I'm thinking that I'm going to breed her and her sister Mocha also in January, and they'll be both with Smokin. Smokin's going to get a lot of attention this year. Okay, the garden. I am so sorry, you guys, that we just did not keep things updated. Everything was so crazy around here. So, so busy, and we were just picking and pulling, and hopefully next year we can take you guys into it more, and the canning process and how I preserve, freeze. Sorry, girls, you can't come in. Not yet. The only thing really left is the tomatoes. As most of you know, we had just devastating fires. We still have fires going on, so please, if you have a mind to, just remember all of the folks affected by the fires and our firefighters out there trying to, my goodness, fight all these fires. But anyways, we got socked in with so much smoke, we couldn't even see back here from our house. Sorry, you're gonna get dizzy. Which is up there. We couldn't see back here. The smoke was so, so heavy. But as you can see, we've cleared off quite a bit. It's a little overcast today, but the result of all that smoke was at 7-9 days, they just quit producing. I'm going to be coming out probably later today or tomorrow. There's still a few on here that are coming off, but it really affected. They've just started in the last couple days putting off more flowers, but it's too late in the season now. We'll freeze before they have a chance to do anything. So I have put up probably about 25 quarts of spaghetti sauce out of these. These are the San Marzanos. Anyways, I've gotten about 25 quarts. My normal guys is 50, so that's how much all of this has affected us. Anyways, yeah, so everything's just kind of not the best year for tomatoes, but of course I'm always thankful for what I did get, so I'm not going to complain too much. I might put in a few extra San Marzano plants next year. I will pick. I'll come through whenever I glean this. And even the green ones, I'll pick. And if you put them in a paper bag, they will slowly ripen. It takes a few weeks, sometimes a few months, but that way, you know, we're still getting our own homegrown tomatoes. But just a devastating year for our tomatoes. I typically give away boxes and boxes of tomatoes, and I have just, everyone has been precious. I don't think I've really thrown any away. So anyways, there's that. Today is the day the Bielefelders got out to free range, so they're happy. Everybody's out doing their thing, which I may not want them in there. That's my asparagus bed. I might have to run them out of there in a minute. So as you can see, the pigs went to the processor. The processor actually came out September 1st and harvested both of the pigs. The white one, she hung at 210 pounds and she was sold. So my client took her, and then the black one is the one that we kept. She was bigger. She weighed in. She hung at 224 pounds. Now that's after, of course, they've skinned and gutted. That's what their hanging weight is. What we ended up with in our freezer was roughly 180 pounds of meat, and about 180 pounds total. There was about 25 pounds of fat, and I render that down. So we're definitely happy with that. Whenever I crunch the numbers on how much it costs to raise one pig, because we keep all of our receipts, so we always know about what it is. You don't need to look at an empty thing. When I crunched the numbers, it ended up being roughly $3.36 a pound at the end. That was for buying the pig, feeding the pig, buying the stuff that we needed, just the little bit we needed to do this, and the kill fee, and the cut and wrap fee, the smoke fee, all of that. Everything included came to, I think it was like $632 total price, which equaled out to, in our freezer, $3.62 a pound, which I'm happy with that. I think we can do better next year. This year we kind of, because we were so sidetracked with so many things going on, we fed them the 19% clear up until butchering day, which a lot of people will pull back and lower the protein and up the fat. We chose not to do that, and I don't know, it worked out really good. I'm going to, next year before we buy a pig, I'm going to see about buying all of our feed in bulk. You know, 1,000, 2,000 pounds at a time. They say about 1,200 pounds, 1,000 to 1,200 pounds is what you need to raise a pig. If I go back in and sit down with all of the receipts and go through that, I'll have a better idea what it costs to raise each one as far as poundage goes. And I'll update in this video, I'll update you here and let you know how many pounds a feed that they required two pigs. So anyways, they're in the freezer. Ours is in the freezer, the black one. She hung at 224. We got roughly 180 pounds of product. So yeah, we're real happy with that. So anyways, moving on. Like I said, it's breeding season, you guys. Aspen should be coming back into heat by this weekend. She was in heat on September 6th, and she is in with Loki. She was bred to Smokin' last year and gave us three beautiful babies. I wanted to see what we would get out of her and Loki. So she's in with Loki this year. Some pulled blue-eyed babies with her udder and teats would be absolutely amazing. She is one of my foundation does, her and Kalani. We worked for 5 years buying, breeding, keeping, buying, breeding, keeping. We whittled our herd down to just her and Kalani and restarted our herd. And she is just absolutely amazing. She kids easily. She has really nice long teats, huge udder, and gives good amount of milk. So I'm very anxious to see what we can get. See, today is day 15, so we should start seeing some heat signs out of her by, what, Friday, Saturday? So she should be bred by this weekend. Same with Kalani. Now, Kalani was with Smokin' last year, and I liked that breeding so well that I will repeat it, and I will continue to repeat it. She hasn't come into heat yet. Our daughter stayed while we went. Jeff and I went on vacation. Christy stayed, and she said that Kalani was in heat when Aspen was, which kind of plays into last year. They were in heat right around the same time. So I expect her to come into heat this weekend also. But this is a breeding that I will continue for as long as we have this beautiful boy. I really like what he throws. He throws some really stout, beautiful kids. So it's all about herd improvement. My goodness, you okay? It's all about herd improvement. It's about, for me, it's about udders and just, you know, what I can get in the pail and their body and width and everything. So anyways, that's where we are with breeding, and I'll hopefully update you guys whenever they are bred. So that's pretty much the gist of it, you guys. Oh, apple trees. Horrible year for apples this year too. I really gleaned down our trees. I didn't want them overloaded with apples, and we had some really nice big apples on there, and yeah, the birds got to most of them, and then the smoke happened, and they just looked horrible this year. We got a good basket full, and I will go ahead and process those into applesauce, but that's the apple. We still have Fuji's on. They look really good. There's a lot of them on there. I didn't glean that tree as well as I should have. So there's a lot of small apples on there. And that'll get us through most of the winter just eating apples. So anyways, these guys out of my asparagus beds. It's kind of an unintended consequence of allowing the chickens to free range in the garden. We're gonna have to shut off the asparagus beds from them. So for now, sorry guys, you can't come back into the garden. You'll just have to free range out here. In the video here, the neighbor's out mowing, and somehow me walking around with a camera and they seeing me with a camera, they don't get the whole YouTube thing, so they think I'm being odd. Anyways, it's too noisy out there right now, so I'm going to go ahead and end this now. Remember, check us out on Facebook, you guys. We have a Facebook page, Hanson Never Done Farms. I'm trying to remember to keep my Instagram updated, and we will check back with you guys this weekend when we take the cedar out of Elsa. Monday, we take the cedar out Monday, so 9 days. We'll update you guys then, and hopefully, keep your fingers crossed, she comes back into heat, and that shot that they gave her took care of everything, and we can get her bred. Anyways, I'll update you guys with Aspen and Kalani, and anything else that goes on around here. Y'all have a good day and keep us, remember Oregon, California, Washington, you know, the fires are still raging. Our firefighters are still out there fighting the fires. You know, there's a lot of people that have been displaced, a lot of farmers that have had to move their animals to safer areas, and it's a mess out here. It's a mess. The West Coast is a mess, you guys. Anyways, give us a like, subscribe, and ring the notification bell, and we'll catch you guys next time. Thanks.